Richard Feynman is a Nobel Prize winning physicist. Doing a little bit of research on his background, it turned out Mr. Feynman, Richard's father, had a huge influence on his upbringing. In this short video, we'll learn a few things from Mr. Feynman in the series of What I Did Right for My Child. Enjoy.
Richard Feynman was an incredible scientist. He spent most of his time at Caltech. The idea of quantum physics, where all these particles are interacting in mysterious ways, he came up with a thing called Feynman diagrams that he won the Nobel Prize for. Perhaps even more importantly, he was an amazing teacher. He did a series of lectures which were for people who didn't specialize in physics. It's such a great example of how he could explain things in a fun and interesting way to anyone.
We had the Encyclopedia Britannica at home. And even when I was a small boy, he used to sit me on his lap and read to me from the Encyclopedia Britannica. Everything we'd read would be translated into some reality, so that I learned to do that. And everything I read, I tried to figure out what it really means, what it's really saying.
Dr. Feynman used a tough process on himself, where if he didn't really understand something, he would push himself. Do I understand this boundary case? Do I understand why we don't do it this other way? Do I really understand this? And because he had pushed himself to have such a deep understanding, his ability to take you through the path of the different possibilities was incredible.
He said to me, say, what's that bird? What's the name of it? Do you know the name of that bird? I says, I have the slightest idea. He said, well, it's a brown-throated thrush. He says, your father doesn't teach you anything. But my father had already taught me about the names of birds. We walked and he says, that's a brown-throated thrush. He says, know what the name of that bird is? A brown-throated thrush. In German, it's called a Fliegenflügel. In Chinese, it's called a Qinglongtong. In Japanese, a Tohatohara, and so on. And when you know all the names in every language of that bird, you know nothing, but absolutely nothing about the bird. And then we would go on and talk about the pecking and the feathers. So I had learned already that names don't constitute knowledge.
Feynman made science so fascinating. He reminded us how much fun it is, and everybody can have a pretty full understanding. So he's such a joyful example of, you know, how we'd all like to learn and think about things.
Hi, this is Phoenix Pan. My one word is potential. Wherever you are, I appreciate you. If you find this vlog interesting, share it. Hit that like button for us. Sharing is caring. Until next time, happy parenting.